think right now there's concerns around global exposures, and Citi probably being the most global of the banks. Trade rhetoric, macro, different things weighing. And so I think people look at that and probably took some pause. Today, I think you've seen people really get through the numbers. The analysts have all come out and written their pieces and are actually really quite constructive in terms of what we're doing.
In terms of what you're doing, you had the big strategy review roughly a year ago, and there was a lot of optimism coming out of that. But since then, you've underperformed year to date, for example, compared to the four big universal banks, your bottom of the pack share price performance. So what is it that needs to be done to change that? Is it in your hands, or is it a macro point, as you say, that you're in the wrong place at the wrong time with your geographic exposure?
Well, let's step back and talk a little bit about what we told people a year ago. We basically said we were going to be focused on delivering three things. One is being able to create sustainable client-led growth. And since then, we've grown client revenues in each of our business segments by about 4%. Second is that we are going to continue to use technology not only to improve customer service, but to bend the cost curve. And we've talked about $2.5 billion of expense saves coming out of that. We've talked about an efficiency ratio continuing to bring that down to the low 50s. We're on our seventh consecutive quarter of delivering against that. And third piece, we said we're going to continue with meaningful capital return. So a year ago, we told people it's our intention and ambition to return about $60 billion of capital over the three capital planning cycles. Just about 3 weeks ago, we received approval again. That now gets us to 41 of the 60. Mm-hmm. And we think we're on track to do that. So a bit of top line growth, good expense discipline, meaningful capital return, exactly what you saw this quarter. 5% EBIT growth translating into 16% income and 27% EPS growth.
As it relates to the stock prices, Mike, do you think there's too much hand-wringing over the yield curve, the shape of the yield curve right now, or is it a legitimate signal that we're going into a recession?
That's the question. And obviously, we go back and forth. You've got a 10-year that's made a couple runs at 3%. I think today probably sits around 285. Last week, I think you have to read Chair Powell's testimony as being quite constructive in terms of the U.S. economy, and I think speaking quite forcefully to two more rate hikes this year. The good news about that rate hikes is they're happening for the right reasons. We're finally getting to and hitting, and I think the Fed's comfortable with their inflation targets. We're seeing growth, good growth in the economy, and the Fed's reacting in a way that's positive because the markets are giving it, or interest rates in the economy are giving it the room to do that. So I don't read too much into that right now.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.